there's another service for running containers, another managed service on AWS, and that's the Amazon Elastic Kubernetes Service, EKS. So I'm going to go over some of the key topics and facts you need to understand for the exam, as EKS does come up quite a bit. So EKS is the Elastic Kubernetes Service. It's also a managed service for running containers. Now, you use it when you need to standardize container orchestration across multiple environments using a managed Kubernetes implementation. So when you're running Kubernetes, you're still essentially running Docker containers, and this provides an orchestration layer over the top. Now, there's a couple of ways you can deploy it. There's a hybrid deployment. That is that you manage the Kubernetes clusters and applications across hybrid environments, and that is AWS and on-premises. Now, you're now able to standardize the orchestration layer for your containers using Kubernetes. You might run it in other clouds as well, like Microsoft Azure. EKS supports batch processing, where you can run sequential or parallel batch workloads on your EKS cluster using the Kubernetes Jobs API. And then you can plan, schedule, and execute batch workloads. EKS supports machine learning as well, using Kubeflow and EC2 GPU-powered instances, including Inferentia. For web applications, you can build web applications that automatically scale up and down in a highly available configuration across multiple AZs. Let's have a look at an example of an infrastructure with EKS. So we have multiple AZs with subnets, and we've got an EKS cluster running on top. The managed Kubernetes service runs on EC2 and Fargate, and also it can run on AWS outposts. You have the EKS control plane, and then you have worker nodes. EKS supports load balancing with the ALB, NLB, and the CLB as well. And groups of containers are known as pods in Kubernetes. There's a concept of autoscaling. You've got cluster autoscaling. This uses something called the vertical pod autoscaler, which automatically adjusts the CPU and memory reservations for your pods to right size your applications. Then we have the horizontal pod autoscaler, which automatically scales the number of pods. So that will help you to be able to ensure you have enough available to support your application. Secondly, there's workload autoscaling. EKS supports two autoscaling products, the Kubernetes Cluster Autoscaler and the Carpenter Open Source Autoscaling Project. The Cluster Autoscaler uses autoscaling groups from AWS, while Carpenter works directly with the EC2 fleet. Now, those do come up in exam questions, so make sure you remember the various different ways that you can scale an EKS cluster. Next, let's move over to the pod networking. EKS supports native VPC networking with the VPC Container Network Interface CNI plugin for Kubernetes. The plugin assigns a private IPv4 or IPv6 address from your VPC to each pod. The VPC CNI plugin for Kubernetes is deployed with each of your ECT nodes in a daemon set with the name AWS-node. And the plugin consists of two components. We've got this LIPAM daemon, and that's responsible for creating the network interfaces, attaching them to instances, assigning secondary IPs to your network interfaces, and it keeps a warm pool of IP addresses on each node for assignment to pods when they're scheduled. Next, there's the CNI plugin. That's responsible for wiring the host network, so doing things like configuring the network interfaces and virtual Ethernet pairs. And it adds the correct network interface to the pod namespace. Lastly, I'm going to cover EKS with elastic load balancing. EKS supports network load balancers and application load balancers. The AWS load balancer controller manages the elastic load balancers for a Kubernetes cluster. You install the AWS load balancer controller using Helm v3 or later, or by applying a Kubernetes manifest. And the controller will provision the following resources. The AWS application load balancer when you create a Kubernetes ingress, and a network load balancer when you create Kubernetes service type of load balancer. In the past, the Kubernetes network load balancer was used for instance targets, but the AWS load balancer controller was used for IP targets. With the load balancer controller version 2.3 or later, you can create NLBs using either target type.